Hello everyone, this is Yamin and welcome to Laravel e-commerce project tutorial. In the previous tutorial, we let the customer add product to their cart. Now in this tutorial, we are going to add a cart option over here and customer will be able to see how many product that they added in the cart. And also customer will be able to, we'll also have a remove option so that customer can remove those from the cart. And we also have one more condition is that only the logged in user can see the cart option. If the customer is not logged in, then they will not be able to see the cart option. So we'll directly go to our code right now. We'll directly go to our home.blade.php. And if we go down, you can see over here a auth option. You can see X app layout. So you can see over here at the rate of auth, it means if the user is logged in, then we'll execute this line. Otherwise, we'll show login and register option. So you can see X app layout is responsible for this user this part. Okay, so we are going to add a list over here inside this auth condition. So let me just copy this list, Control C, and I'll paste it after the auth. And over here, instead of contact us, we'll say cart. And if we save it now, and if we refresh, you will see a cart option over here. You can see a cart option. Now this doesn't look like a cart, so we'll add a like cart icon before this, and we'll also have a option so that user can see how many products that they added in the cart. So let's add the cart icon over here. So we'll if you just search for cart icon font awesome, and if you press enter, if you just go to the first link, you can see a cart icon over here. So if you just click this Fafa cart, it will automatically get copied. And let's go to our code and we'll add this before the cart. So let me just press enter. So inside this anchor tag, we'll just paste this icon. If we save it now and if we refresh, you will see something like this, but this isn't a cart icon, right? Because we are using a font awesome icon. So for using font awesome icon, we also need to add the font awesome CDN. So we'll just search for over here font awesome CDN, and if you press enter, you will see option like this. And if you just click this link, set up web font with CDN, you can see a web page like this. And if you go down, you will see this font awesome icon. So let me just copy it, and I will also give it in the description so that you can just directly copy it from there. So I'll just copy it and I'll just directly paste it inside my home home blades head, inside this head part. So Control V, Control S. Now if we refresh, we'll see a cart icon over here. You can see a cart icon. Now we'll have 2/3 bracket over here. So after this cart, let me just add 2/3 bracket, and inside this we are actually going to show how many product that the customer have in their cart. So let me just save it, and if we just refresh now, it will see a little bit different. You will see it like this. So now let's go to our code and let's show that how many product customer added in their cart. So for it, we'll directly go to our home controller, and inside home controller, from this redirect function, we are actually returning the user.home view after login. So we are going to add some more code over here. So over here, first of all, we'll get the customer first who is logged in. So for it, let's just first we need to declare a variable. So let's say over here $user is equal to, we'll say auth, then this arrow sign, we'll say user. So now we'll be able to get the user which is logged in currently. And after this, we need to count how many products that they added in the cart. So for it, let's just declare another variable. We'll say over here count is equal to, we have to say our table name which is cart, and then we'll give a condition where, then inside it we need to say now let me just go to the cart table. Let me just show you something. And over here inside this card table, you can see we have the username, phone number and address. Now using any of them, we can actually find how many product user added in the card. But we'll use this phone number because every person in the world has a unique phone number, but name can be same. So we will use phone number to count how many product that they added in the card. So for it, let's go back to our code, and over here we'll say phone. This phone will come from the card database, and after phone we will give a comma, and then over here we'll say this $user, this arrow sign, we'll say phone. So we'll get the specific user phone number that is logged in, and after this we'll just say this arrow sign count. So now what will happen, let me just explain it again. First of all, we are actually getting the user which is logged in. Then we are over here, we are getting the user phone number from the user table, and we are comparing it with our card table phone number column, and we are in the end we are returning the count how many of the same phone number is in the card. So after this we need to add this count inside this compact. So after this data we'll give another comma, then inside single quotation we'll say count. So let's save it now over here. Now we'll go to our user.home, which is this one, home.blade.php, and over here you can see the cart, and inside it we'll give 2 second bracket and we'll say dollar count. And if we save it now, control S, and if we refresh, you can see 10 over here. Now as I also mentioned that only the logged in user can see the card. If the user is not logged in, they cannot see the card. So if you just because we added this li inside this auth condition, so if you now log out, you won't be able to see the card option. So here you can see there is no card option. Now let's log in again. So again you can see the card option over here. So now what we'll do is that if the user click this card option, it will take the user to different page, and user will be able to see all the product that they added in their cart. So for it, let's go back to our code again, and over here you can see a href. Now inside this href we are going to mention a URL. We'll say URL and we'll say show cart. So now we'll go to our web.php and create this URL. So let's go to web.php and let me just copy this one, control C and control V. We'll say over here show cart, and then the function name will be, let's say, show cart as well. So let's save it, control S. So now let's go to our home controller and let's go at the end, and now we'll say public function show cart, then we are going to return a view. Let's say it name will be user, we'll keep user dot let's say show cart. The blade name will be show card as well. So let's save it now, control S. Now we will go to our user folder, which is over here, and inside it we are going to create this show card blade. So let's just right click on the user, then click new file. We'll say show card.blade.php. So now control S and save. So inside it, we are just going to copy everything from our home.blade.php. Let me just copy everything from the home.blade.php. Control A, Control C, and we'll paste inside showcard.blade.php. So Control V. Now we do not require everything from the home.blade.php. We'll only have up until this header part. We'll remove everything after the header. So let me just remove everything up until this footer. So if we remove it, and let's save it now, control S, and let me just refresh over here. And if you click the cart, you can see a undefined variable dollar count, because over here in the show cart we have this dollar count, but if we go to our home controller, over here we did not send any count variable from here. So let me just go up and I'll just copy this two line from here, Control C, then I'll paste it over here, Control V, and after this show card I'll comma compact, and inside it we'll say count, and let's save it now and let's refresh. So you can see that we have the navbar over here. Now over here we are going to create a table and show all the product that the user added in the cart. So let's go back to our code and we'll go to our showcart.blade.php, and we are going to mention a table over here. We'll say table, and inside it let's have some tr. Inside tr we'll have td. Tr means table load, td means table data. Let's say we'll have now we do not require to show name, phone number, address. We'll only show the product title, quantity, and the product price. So let's go and we'll say over here product name, and after product name let me just copy it and paste it two times. After product name we'll have quantity, and this one will be the price. And let's also so save this now, and if you go to our browser and refresh, okay, we cannot see the table. I think it is just behind this navbar. So let me just give a div over here, and this div will end over here, and let's say over here a style, and inside the style we'll say padding. Let's say padding 100px, and if we save it and refresh now, so here you can see product name, quantity, price. So let's make some design. Let's say over here we'll say align, it will be center, and inside this tr we are going to say again style. We'll have a background color, it will be let's say gray. So let's say background color will be gray. So let's save it now, Control S, and let's refresh. So here you can see the background color is gray right now. Now inside this td let's also add some style. Let's say over here style is equal to, we'll also add padding 10px, and font size will be 20px. So let's just let me just copy this style, Control C, and paste it inside this, and this td, Control V, Control S. Now if we refresh we'll see it like this. I think this looks better than before. Now let's show all the product over here. So for it we again need to go to our homecontroller.blade.php, and over here you can see that we already get the specific user that is logged in. So we are just going to declare another variable. So let's say over here dollar cart is equal to, we'll say again cart, which is our table name. Then we'll mention a where condition, and inside it we are going to say the same thing that we before. Let's say we'll say over here phone comma dollar user phone, this arrow sign phone. Now this time it will be just without this count function. So we'll save it now, and after this count we'll give another single quotation, and inside it we'll say cart. So let me just explain it. Over here using this phone function, using this phone condition, we are actually getting which product that specific user added to their cart, and we are sending that specific product to our user.showcart view. So let me just explain it again from this database. So over here using this phone, we are comparing this phone number with the user that is logged in, and we are sending those data that contain the same phone number to the showcart view. So let's go to our showcard.blade.php. So over here, so we are going to mention another tier, and inside it we'll obviously have multiple TD. So let me just copy this TD and paste it 2 times. Ctrl V. So now inside this TD first, but before that let's just add the for each loop over here. So we'll set the rate of for each, then we'll say dollar cart as, let's say dollar cart, and this for each loop will end after this tier. So we'll say at the rate of end for each. So over here you can see the dollar cart, this is coming from the home controller from here. So inside this TD we will give 2 second bracket, then we need to say these cards, dollar cards. So we'll say dollar cards, then arrow sign. We need to say the product name. Let me just go to our table, and over here you can see product name is actually product titles, and we have quantity and price. So we're going to say over here product underscore title, and let me just copy this, Ctrl C Ctrl V and Ctrl V. So this one will be quantity, and this one will be the price. So let's save it, Ctrl S, and let's just refresh now. Okay, there is no data. Let me just check in the code again. Over here everything is okay. Let's go to home controller. Okay, over here we need to say this arrow sign get. Now we'll be able to get the cart data. Now if we refresh, we'll see the product over here. So let's also add some design over here as well. So let's go back to our code again. We'll directly go to show cart, and inside this TD, let's say this time, inside this style background color, it will be black. And inside this TD, let's also mention the style. We'll say padding 10px, just like before. And font size, I think it's okay. Let's all just add a color over here, the text color, which will be white. So let me just copy this style, Ctrl C, and I'll paste it over here and here as well. So let's save it, and let's just refresh now. So you can see it like this. I think the design is fine. Okay, let's also change the table header color as well. So let me just make it black instead of gray. Let's say our hair black, and we'll also make their color, text color, white. So let me just select Ctrl V, Ctrl S, and let's refresh. Okay, this looks, I think, better. You can change their design more if you want. So this is it for this tutorial. In the next tutorial, we'll add another column over here, and we'll also add a remove button so that customer can remove some product from their cart. So this is it for this tutorial, and please subscribe this channel if you like this video and if you got help from this tutorial. And I upload on video every 24 hours related to Laravel. So if you want to learn Laravel more, then please subscribe this channel, and thank you for watching, and I hope you have a really great day.